hello, everybody. I am so honored and blessed to be here with all of you.
Intuition is all about being in our hearts. And, you know, my work is centered around being strategic, finding, reaching out and understanding the intuitive, the spiritual, the guides, all the information that is available to us, and then processing it through our hearts so that we really understand it, we trust it, and then we have the confidence to step out and take those inspired actions.
I believe that the ultimate well-being is when body, mind, spirit, and soul are all in balance.
A positive is that it really created this space, the sacred space for us to just ask those questions of ourselves that I have to choose, right? I have to make the decision to just unplug and trust, because on one hand, I'm allowing myself to get plugged into the denseness. He reminded me that love has won the day. Love has won the day. And so with that, everything else has to be polarized so we can see where love is not in existence.
The way I see, it kind of goes back to shadow work, right? So we have to be able to see those shadow aspects of ourselves. We need to be able to understand where we're not being authentic, where we are allowing those injured parts of ourselves to drive the train or run the show, whatever terminology you want to use.
And what goes on outside is what's going on inside, really. It all boils back to us as individuals. And that's where the ball starts rolling, and it has the ripple effect. So when we begin to love ourselves and honor ourselves and accept ourselves, then we're better able to see other people and see their value and see their worth and realize that we are of the same spark.
We are of the spark, right? So there's nothing broken. There's nothing that needs to be fixed. There's nothing wrong with you. Each of us were created special, right? Each of us were created different from anyone else, right? But in the large scheme of things, we're the ones responsible for our own happiness. And it's up to us to do those things that make us happy.
Absolutely, they're giving away their power because tomorrow might never come. All we are promised is today, right now, this moment. And so if you're always looking for that dangling carrot to make you happy, you'll never be happy. It's a choice that you live in for today and for this moment, right? So like Nori said, if your husband's not making you happy, well, it's not up to him to make you happy. It's up to yourself.
No one else is responsible to make your life okay. No one else is responsible to fill your happiness cup, right? And that you have the power to fill your cup at any time. So whatever's happening, you're in charge of your thoughts. You have power over your thoughts, and you can choose the thoughts you think, and you can change the thoughts you think, and you can change the beliefs that you choose to believe, and you can choose to take your power back at any time.
You know, you cannot control what happens to you, but you can control how you react to whatever it is.
That there are no limits to where you can go in your mind or your imagination, and there are no rules.
You have the power, and you are more than able to change your world.
That energy, the guides, they are here to support us, to help us be the best version of ourselves that we can.